Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, dear brothers and sisters. Welcome back to our series, People of Quran, where every night I share with you a story from one of our pious predecessors and how they interacted with the Quran. So this is actually a very powerful story, subhanAllah. It's one that, that truly I think relates to many young people today in particular that are struggling with zina, the zina of the eyes, you know, the fornication of the eyes, the fornication of the hands, and unfortunately sometimes, you know, full fornication, full adultery. And this is narrated by Imam bin Kathir, rahimahullah ta'ala, and also Muhammad Siddiq al-Minshawi in the stories of Umar al-Khattab, radiallahu anhu. And it's about a young man. And this young man, you know, shabun fi ahdi Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a young man in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kana yulazimul masjid, who was, you know, well known for constantly attending the masjid. So this isn't the highway robber, this is someone that always used to go to the masjid. Liyasma' al-hadith ghadlan tariyan, min afwah as-sahaba, so that he could hear the ahadith being recited from the mouths of the sahaba, may Allah be pleased with them. And, you know, in particular, Umar bin Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, you know, saw this young man as one with great potential. So Umar radiallahu anhu takes this young man as a student. And, you know, this young man was always seen following Umar bin Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu. وَكَانَ لَهُ أَبْوٌ شَيْخٌ, he had an old father that, you know, he used to constantly go home and serve every single night. His mother had passed away, so it was just him and his father. And every night when he left the masjid, as he was on his way to his father, كان على طريقه امرأة, there was a beautiful young lady that used to constantly call him to commit adultery. And subhanAllah, he would always ignore her. He would head to his father's house, and he didn't pay attention to her. And then one day, you know, and that's how it works with shaitan, right? He catches you in a vulnerable moment. One day, as he was walking and she started to tempt him, as she always did, he actually followed her. And subhanAllah, as he went behind her, لَمَّا أَرَادَ أَن يَدْخُلَ الْبَيْتَ خَلْفَهَا, just as he was about to enter into the house behind her, he remembered the ayah. And this is the ayah we're covering today. Now we're in the seventh surah, Surah Al-A'raf. Verse 201, تذكر قول الله, he remembered these words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا إِذَا مَسَّهُمْ طَائِفٌ مِّنَ الشَّيْطَانِ تَذَكَّرُوا فَإِذَا هُمْ مُبُصِرُونَ, that indeed those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they're touched by an impulse of shaitan, you know, shaitan gets them, you know, just quickly, they're touched by a whisper of shaitan, an impulse of shaitan, تَذَكَّرُوا, you know, as soon as that happens, they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's a moment of heedlessness, and then right away they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَإِذَا هُمْ مُبُصِرُونَ, and they snap out of it. Suddenly they can see clearly. So it's like, it's a moment of vulnerability. Shaytan gets you on an impulse. He gets you into a moment of heedlessness to do something you're going to regret. And then, you know, that taqwa kicks in and you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He remembered this ayah from Surah Al-A'raf. And as soon as he remembered this ayah from Surah Al-A'raf, خَرَّ مَغْشِيًا عَلَيْهِ, you know, he collapsed completely in front of this young lady's house. And this, you know, subhanAllah, this young lady actually picked him up, حُمِّلَ إِلَىٰ أَبِي, and she dropped him in front of his father's house. And his father, you know, brought him inside the house, and they thought that he might die. And, you know, his father, you know, read Qur'an on him. And this young man woke up, and he feared Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so much, and he felt so bad for what he'd done, that he started to share this story with his father. His father said, what happened? What caused you to fall into this? So he started to tell him what happened. And then as he was starting to tell him what happened, and he was saying that, you know, I remembered an ayah from the Qur'an, his father said, what was that ayah that you remembered? And as he started to recite that ayah again, he passed out again, but this time he didn't wake up. So subhanAllah, he actually passed away. And Umar bin Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu was called to the house, and he came and he was very grieved. And they took him and they actually prayed janazah on him that night. And subhanAllah, this is where a miracle happens. As Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu buried him and he cried and they prayed on him, Umar bin Khattab radiallahu anhu said, Ya fata, waliman khafa maqama rabbihi jannatan. He said, O young man, and he recited the 46th ayah of Surah Ar-Rahman, whoever fears the standing before his Lord will have two gardens, two jannas. And when Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said that, the young man actually responded from his grave. And that's why Ibn Kathir has this section, شَابٌ يَتَحَدَّثْ مِنْ قَبْرِهِ, a young man who spoke from his grave. The young man actually responded to Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu and said, Ya Umar, قَدْ أَعْطَانِيهِمَا رَبِّي فِي الْجَنَّةِ مَرَّتَيْنِ, Allah has given me these gardens in Jannah twice. Meaning Allah has given me even double what you assume of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give me. And what this shows you is that, you know, again, the ayah in Surah Al-A'raf, yes, Allah will catch you sometimes, the shaitan will catch you sometimes where you don't expect, but if you have that consistent relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you'll eventually overcome that impulse, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most forgiving and most merciful, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward that taqwa. We ask Allah to grant us that same consciousness and that taqwa, that we meet Him while He's pleased with us, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows us to overcome the whispers of shaitan and the corruption of ourselves. Allahumma ameen. Jazakumullahu khairan. Inshallah ta'ala, I'll see you next time on our series, People of Quran. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.